Hi, today we will learn about stainless steel. Our group members are Ridwan Syakir, Muhammad Syamil, Azmi, Imran, Syafiq and Nabil. What is the stainless steel means?
Stainless is a term coined early in the development of these steels for cutlery applications. It was adopted as a generic name for these steels and now covers as a wide range of steel types and grades of corrosion or oxidation resistant application. Stainless steels are iron alloys with a minimum of 10.5% chromium. Other alloying elements are added to enhance their structure and properties such as formability, strength and cryogenic toughness. These include metals such as nickel, molybdenum, titanium, and copper. Non-metal additions are also made, the main ones being carbon, nitrogen.
The main requirement for stainless steel is that they should be corrosion resistant for a specific application or environment. So, what form of corrosion can occur in stainless steel? The most common forms of corrosion in stainless steel are pitting corrosion, device corrosion, general corrosion, stress corrosion cracking, intergranular corrosion, galvanic corrosion.
So, pitting corrosion. The passive layer on a stainless steel can be attacked by certain chemical species. Pitting corrosion is avoided by making sure that stainless steel does not come into prolonged contact with harmful chemicals or by choosing a grade of steel which is more resistant to attack.
Revive corrosion. Stainless steel requires a supply of oxygen to make sure that the passive layer can form on the surface. Second, in very tight crevices, it is not always possible for the oxygen to gain access to the stainless steel surface, thereby causing it to be vulnerable to attack. General corrosion. Normally, stainless steel does not corrode uniformly as do ordinary carbon and alloy steels, but with some chemicals, notably acid, the passive layer may be attacked uniformly depending on concentration and temperature, and the metal loss is distributed over the entire surface of the steel. Stress corrosion cracking. First, stainless steel requires a supply of oxygen to make sure that the passive layer can form on the surface. Second, this is a relative rare form of corrosion which requires a very specific combination of tensile stress, temperature and corrosive species, often the chloride ion, for it to occur. The typical application where SCC can occur are hot water tank and swimming pool. Galvanic corrosion. If two dissimilar metals are in contact with each other and with an electrolyte, example, water or other solution, it is possible for a galvanic cell to be set up. This is rather like a battery and can accelerate corrosion of the less noble metal.
So how many types of stainless steel are there? Stainless steel is usually divided into 5 types: ferritic, austenitic, martensitic and duplex. Based on chromium with small amounts of carbon, limited in use to relative thin section due to lack of toughness in webs, cannot be hardened by heat treatment. High chromium steels with addition of molybdenum can be used in quite aggressive conditions, resistant to stress corrosion cracking, not as formable, magnetic. Austenitic. Corrosion resistance can be enhanced by adding chromium, molybdenum and nitrogen. Cannot be hardened by heat treatment. Able to be work hardened to high strength levels. Useful level of ductility and toughness. Vulnerable to stress corrosion cracking. Non-magnetic. Martensitic. Similar to ferritic steels based on chromium but have higher carbon level up as high as 1%. Hardened and tempered much like carbon and low alloy steels. High strength and moderate corrosion resistant, more common in long products than in sheet and platforms, low weldability and formability, magnetic. Duplex, 15% ferritic and 15% austenitic, higher strength than either ferritic or austenitic steels, resistant to stress corrosion cracking. Super duplex steel have enhanced strength and resistant to all forms of corrosion, weldable but need care in selection of welding, consumable and heat input, moderate. Formability, magnetic but not so much as the ferritic.
Mechanical properties of stainless steel. yield strength of stainless steel. The yield strength of any austenitic stainless steel is a very low proportion of the tensile strength. Mild steel yield strength is typically 65 to 70 of the tensile strength. Cold working rapidly and greatly increases the yield strength. Ductility of stainless steel. The combination of high work hardening rates and the high elongation makes stainless steel very easy to fabricate. Stainless steel can be severely deformed in operation like deep drawing. Ductility is normally measured as the percentage elongation before fracture during tensile testing. Anneal austenitic stainless steel have exceptionally high elongation. Hardness of stainless steel. Hardness is the resistance to penetration of the material surface. Hardness testers measure the depth that a very hard indenter, Brinell, Rockwell and Vickers machine are used. Each of these has a different shape indenter and method of applying the known force. Martensitic and precipitation hardening grades can be hardened by heat treatment. Tensile strength of stainless steel. Tensile strength is generally the only mechanical properties required to define bar and wire products. Identical material grades may be used at various tensile strengths for completely different applications. The supplied tensile strength of bar and wire products directly relates to the final use after fabrication. The high strength is imparted by cold working.
Physical properties of stainless steel. The reason for choosing stainless steel is normally due to advantages given by physical properties such as corrosion resistance. In addition to corrosion resistance, the advantages physical properties of stainless steel include high and low temperature resistance, ease of fabrication, high strength, aesthetic appeal, hygiene and ease of cleaning, long life cycle, recyclable, and low magnetic permeability.
Domestic cutlery, sinks, saucepan, washing machine drums, microwave oven liners and razor blades. Architectural or civil engineering. Cladding, handrails, door and window fitting. Street furniture, structural section, reinforcement bar, lighting columns, lintels and masonry supports. Transport. Exhaust system, car trims or grills, road tankers, ship containers, ship chemical tankers and refuse vehicle. Chemical or pharmaceutical, pressure vessel or process piping. Medical, surgical instruments, surgical implants, MRI scanner, oil and gas, platform accommodations, cable trays, subsea pipelines.
Conclusion. Stainless steel is an attractive material for a variety of applications, usually due to corrosion resistance and strength, but sometimes also for aesthetic. Designers that are new to stainless steel can find the choice of grades confusing. Steel is considered to be more a specialist material and only used where essential.
On the other hand, for some applications such as those in the food, pharmaceutical and chemical industries, the use of stainless steel is all about the essential because of its corrosion resistance. One of the advantages of the corrosion resistance is that stainless steel is readily recyclable. Unlike with carbon steel, which might be badly corroded or contaminated with finishes such as paint or plating, stainless steel is 100% recyclable.